No.
If you wake up this night and say, for the next 120 nights, I'm going to be upstanding from 12 midnight to 2 a.m. I'm not going to have any prayer point. I will just stand, speak in tongues for 2 hours and go sleep. Before you finish 47 days, you will hear an announcement. You don't need to be, you don't need to be a prophet before you pick these frequencies. The moment you begin to keep your watch, the prophetic will open. The reason is because of the prayer of Moses. You know Moses prayed a prayer in the Old Testament, in the book of Numbers, chapter 11. He said, I wish that all the Lord's children were prophets and that he will put his spirit upon them. The prayer that Moses prayed in the book of Numbers, chapter 11, God answered in the New Testament, because in the New Testament, he put his spirit upon all of us. So anyone here that is born again has the spirit of God upon his life. And Jesus, trying to educate us, told us that when the spirit of truth is come, there are several packages he comes with. First of all, he will guide us into all truth. That means he will take us into the realm of reality. He will furnish reality upon our hearts so that we can have capacity to handle things that are not visible, to hear things that are not audible, to manipulate things that we were not taught, because we have the Holy Ghost. Such abilities are supposed to become the description of our everyday life because of our interfacing perpetually with the Holy Spirit. He said, when the Spirit of truth is come, he will show you things to come. That means, whereas you are limited by time and space, the Holy Ghost is not reckoned by time. He dwells in the realm of the eternal now. The past, the present, and the future is one for him. And so, because of the leanness and the deficiency of our frame of reference, which is called time, he can give you strategic insight of things that are yet to come. There is no way, and this is not for prophets, this is for people that have access to the Holy Ghost. I'm not talking about people that have gifts, a gift of the Spirit. I'm talking about people that have the Spirit. So if you decide to wake up and say, all right, because that was how I woke up when my father died, a good man, I discovered that what you need to survive is not just being good. If there was any man that had to live because of his goodness, it was my father. He had to live. He must live. But he died. And he died untimely. And you know how children look helpless when their father died. I've been there before. As I was crying that time, as many people, I don't know what people were crying about, but I can tell you why I cried. My own cry was that I didn't know God enough to stop him from dying. And what his death did was that it made me to arm myself, to go on pilgrimage, a journey into God, and never to come back until I find him. I'm preaching here today because I found him. I pray somebody will be provoked. I pray somebody's heart will be stirred up, that I will journey until I find him. When you begin to find him, maybe you stand up in the night. So I'm going for 200 days, night vigil, 12 to 2. You will not even reach 60 before you start hearing announcements. The fact that you heard announcements is a proof that you have stumbled into his corridor, because that's the nature of our God. When he, the Spirit of truth, is come. You can be baptized in the Holy Ghost, but the Spirit of truth is not yet come to you. You will need to wake up and take your place as a watchman and begin to practice your responsibility as one that is waiting to hear God. What's the next policy of heaven? What's the next agenda? So that I can begin to implement it. If that is your heart, he will come to you and he will speak to you. I know there are days when I monopolize God. Me, like this, as small as I am, I monopolize it. I've kept him in my room for 7 hours before. I don't know whether he was talking to you then, but he was with me. I don't know whether there was blackout in your own space, but I trapped him for 7 hours. And by the time I came after the 7 hours talk with God, I knew what to do. I knew where to go. I knew who to call. I knew who to answer. I knew the people's number on my phone to block for life. When you hear announcements, you become wise. Because most of the announcements are futuristic. It makes you strategic. Are you with me? If you know that Indomie will become scarce and one Indomie pack will become 7,000, you will buy the factory. Oh, announcements can change your story overnight. It's because, you are not here.
Do you still believe the Bible? He said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Your poverty is because he is not your shepherd. There are things you will never enjoy in the covenant. Don't allow a babbling preacher deceive you. The preacher himself, look at his own life. Has he seen the light? You will know. Because in theological school, they teach them how to talk. Does he know Jehovah? Someone that knows Jehovah, there'll be evidences to show. It's not just talk. He will command some supernatural dimensions that science cannot explain. It means he's doing business in the deep waters. So if he speaks to you, you can now believe him. If somebody doesn't have any supernatural evidences to show, he has not met God. He studies much so he can talk, just like a medical doctor. Study for 6 years. If you go before him, he will use one thing. He will put it here. Put it here. Put it here. And tell you, you are almost dead. The Holy Ghost will make you strategic, but the average believer will never wait on him. He will do other things. He can complain. He can even travel to the village and consult an oracle. He will wear face cap. The other day, you're not with me. The other day, an elder in the church, he went to Angpa. I'm talking about, you know Angpa, where they consult a spirit called Emere. Emere. He put face cap so that nobody will know he's the elders. Elders visit devious for insight. The reason is because he believes it's a burden to enter into the lay of God. I want to challenge you. It's easier to hear God than to hear the devil. The reason is because you are born again and the Spirit of God is in your heart. Do you know the implication of that? How many of you bought a handset recently? Handset. Is there anybody you bought a handset? Before you inserted the SIM, the calculator can work. Is that true? The touchlight can work. You can check the calendar and check date. Did you buy the handset because of date? You bought it because of touchlight. You bought it because you wanted communication. Is that true? But you see, the communication can never find expression until you introduce a SIM card. The SIM card can interpret the potential of the network, give you accessibility. You can browse with it, check your mail, send a text message, chat with somebody in Los Angeles, just because you have SIM card. That's what happened to you. The day you gave your life to Christ, the Holy Ghost is a SIM card. It was inserted into your spirit man. You see, the design is that you are a vessel. You need a SIM card to operate. A bag of potential. But except the SIM card is inserted, it's only calculator and touchlight that will be working. Your ultimate purpose will be neglected. And most of you have built your life on things that are departures from your ultimate purpose. The moment you insert the SIM card of the Holy Ghost into your vessel, you become compatible with heaven's network. You can pick things happening in the lay of God. It was Jesus that said that, not me. In the book of John, chapter 3. Turn your Bible. Turn your Bible. Because with this issue of announcements, 90% of the people in this hall, it's been long since you heard an announcement. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, the ruler of the Jews. They said he came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God, for no man can do these miracles that thou do except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. So the kingdom of God is a layer of civilization, a layer of reality, but you will need to be born again before you can peep into that layer of civilization. The layer of civilization exists, but you'll be cut off from it permanently, perpetually, until you become born again. And when you become born again, the Holy Ghost is inserted into your spirit man. And the implication is that it gives you awareness of what is happening in the layer of God. You understand that? So when you decide to make prayer a preoccupation, like I did many years ago, I thought, oh, you are not here. You are not here. You are not here. You are not here. You are not here.
I beheld the demons troubling my family. I saw an owl. The owl stood on the top of our house, and the owl was dancing by this. And as the owl was dancing up there, my elder brother became mad inside the sitting room. I was outside. I saw the owl dancing. Saw my brother, man. Hey. Satan was a mystery to us. Everybody was afraid of Satan. Just like you are now. When they say Aleku, Aleku, you escape from there. And if you go to the village, they'll say, nobody should mention Aleku. Good. Have you seen Aleku? Eh? I made up my mind. I was going to seek God. That was when I knew that I was already connected to the network. So when I decided to seek the face of God, God began to make announcements. It was through the announcements God was making that I now started understanding that the things that I've been afraid of were supposed to be afraid of me. Aleku is supposed to be afraid that I'm here. Oh. We were traveling recently. Someone that loves me dearly came and said, you will not see the people on the road. The kind of prayer that they pray for you. And then you say, amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I told the person, the people on the road need to be afraid of me. There's an understanding I have. I have seen where power dwells. You know, you have not gone close. That's why you are a fearful creature. I've seen where light dwells. I've seen it. I've seen where you hear of the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. I have seen him. The Holy Ghost. I have seen him. There are things you will see. It will knock out fear from your soul. It's because you have not been receiving announcements that you think you are just the third born of a family of seven. If you are doing census, and you count Gabriel, say 001. You count, say 002. Count John, say 002. If you now reach Moses, how can you count Moses? Is he 003? Is Moses one man? What? How will you don't understand. This Moses, this one Moses, went into Egypt and challenged the gods of Egypt. They are gods. You are not with me. Do you know how many people have been held in the bondage of terror because of those gods? The 12 gods of Egypt, a mortal that has flesh and blood in his veins, he appeared with a stick, and through him judgment came upon the 12 gods of Egypt. When you read your Bible, sometimes drop it and think, was that one man? The gods of Egypt had to be afraid of Moses. Moses has heard announcements from God that has changed his thinking. You are thinking like a fugitive, thinking like an escapee. If somebody has stayed in prison before, when they maybe kidnappers kidnap you, when you come back home, if you hear, what do we think is? The Lord will have to give us some announcements to recalibrate our thinking, so that we can be ready for great things. The things, the darkness that bedeviled people in your family. If you receive the right announcements, your own case will be different. Once upon a time, I was praying. I was praying because I noticed, I saw my grandfather. He was like 100-something years old. He never used a walking stick. He had a straight back. In fact, he was begging to die. He had good eyesight, no spectacles. My granddad begging to die. I knew my grandmother, 90 years old, not sickly, not in the hospital, strong. Then my granddad died, now died. And when my grandmom heard he had died, she died. That was a great love life. Hallelujah. So they buried them side by side. This is my grandfather I'm talking about. He married 5 wives. But at the end of the day, it was his first wife that lived with. The rest have died. So the Django man, his first wife, stayed with him to care for him, and the knowledge of his death led to her own death. God, Jesus. Do you realize that after that man died, till this day that I speak to you, nobody in my family has been able to live up to 70 years. Meanwhile, I saw him at what? 100. Oh, do these things bother you at all? Do they bother you? Or they don't bother you? So I said, I wanted to find out why there was untimely death in my family. And I was going to keep the watches until I hear an announcement from God about the issue of untimely death in my family. I was a youth copper posted to Kano. My residence was at Bompai Police Barrack. So when the footballers finish training on the football field and they leave, that's where my prayer starts. There was only one reason why I was on that pitch. Moving from one goal post to another goal post, from one goal post to another goal post. Why was I there? I wanted to find out why there was untimely death in my family. I'm praying today that someone... Meanwhile, are you there? Are you with me? Now, listen to me. Before I was determined to know the mind of God concerning the untimely death in my family, I didn't know the experience of what it means for you to seek God and get a response from Him before that time. You get that? I didn't know how God was going to answer me, but I read my Bible. I found out that our God is literate, our God is alive, our God speaks, and our God answers. And that was enough for me. That guideline was enough for me. And I came to the football field and I'll pray in tongues from one goalpost to the other goalpost. And I say, Jehovah, if you are there, hear my cry. I want to know why people don't live long in my family. You have enlisted among the watchmen. Only the watchmen ask questions. The first secret of spiritual intelligence, I will say it again and again until you hear it. God does not speak much. He only answers much. Only people that come to Him seeking to know, seeking spiritual intelligence, seeking insights. When you begin to desire insight, oh, He becomes proud of you. Because that's the way to ascend the mountain of grace. And I began to call upon Him. Why do people die early? My dad was young. He was just 62. He had excelled. 62 years cut off. You will hear this, my uncle has died 64, 65, 61. Ah! So I said, you know, when you see a pattern, then an intelligence is involved. So I had to go to the hill of the Lord. And I began to pray. First night, second night. And guess what? The answers were not forthcoming, so I now added fasting. Sometimes you need to add spices to your endeavor. You want to go to Boko and your car dies at 100. It's not because it has problem. There's no fuel. Just push it. Please help me tell your neighbor, put fuel. Bakorima. I cried out. Because when you begin to pray like that, watch for signs. Sometimes God can speak to you. Sometimes God can speak through other people. Sometimes God, you can be attending a service and God possesses the preacher. And suddenly he can no longer preach his sermon. He begins to use his vocal cord to speak to you. If you are a watchman and you know where to read, you will find your answers. I pray. And in the dream of the night, the Lord came to me. I will tell you about the work of angels, how angels operate. And I assure you, many angels have visited you, every one of you in this place. But the ability to discern them is the issue. So as we go further in the lecture of the watchmen, you will be told and taught how to interface with messengers from the realm of divinity. And just in case you are in doubt, the day we teach on how to interface with messengers, I will do a practical.
I will do a practical and show you some things in heaven, how they can manifest here. Maybe it will add to your faith and encourage you to believe that this preacher knows what he's talking about. He has seen it. The Lord visited. And the Lord showed me that his deliverance in my family will not be instant. It will take place at a time when a child, a male child, will be born. You see, there are many mysteries in the workings of God. Except you stay with God for a long time, you will not know him. And if you speak for him, you'll be lying. Because the kingdom of God operates by mysteries. You need to be a student of the Holy Ghost for like 10 years for you to understand the patterns of his speaking. So that when you stand and you speak for him, it is consistent with the patterns that you have learned. And even if you are not speaking by inspiration and you spoke by experience, if someone runs with it, he will not lose his way. The Lord showed me that it was the deliverance of our family was going to coincide with the birth of a man child into our family. I must have told you this story before. And I checked to see when this child will be born. Fortunately for me, he was talking about my child. I was not married then. I didn't know my wife when I started that prayer. But the God we speak of is not restricted by space, by time. The bridge between the heavens and the earth is a watchman. A man that seeks to know becomes the answer to the cry of a generation. I had received an announcement. This shall be the sign of my visitation. From the time I received that announcement, I began to give praise to God because I have seen the policy direction of heaven in keeping with the issues of my family. Now I waited to see the signs of when that which God has spoken will come to pass. I think it was the year after I saw my wife. Our courtship was 5 years. Then she took in months after our wedding. And when I went to the hospital and took my son up, I saw that he was the boy I saw in my vision. Because I've received the announcement, whenever I prayed, I knew it was time. The powers of darkness in my family had expired. So I point to my family. I said, the power in you that has brought this sorrow, I curse you. You know the authority of my cursing is in keeping with what? An understanding of the timing. Oh, you are not with me. Thou shall arise and have mercy on Zion. For the time to favor her, yea, that said time is come. I curse the powers, the spirits, the altar, the priest that gave Satan access to my family. The iniquity that fueled and gave Satan the authority to waste. The time of the validity of that iniquity had passed. And God had shown me that the time of redemption, the door of the redemption had opened. I did the work of a watchman. As I called forth redemption, I called forth salvation, I called forth. In order for the Holy Spirit to encourage me, he told me how long I will live. If you hear there was a bomb and people died, I'm not there. That there was a stray bullet, police was angry, and one shot without instruction. Somebody fell. Don't bother to check. I'm not the one. Ooh. I heard some announcements. The wickedness, the darkness. The darkness had to stay. Because when you get to the age of 21, in my own nuclear family, Satan will visit you. And after the war I fought, my siblings escaped the vengeance. And I knew a new season had started for us. Why sit we still until we die? That's the question. When will you awake? When will you be provoked? Except you hear an announcement from God, there is nothing suggestive of the fact that the seasons are about to change. He said, in the city of David,
a savior is born.
The people taking care of their sheep, their flock by night, didn't know what was going on. Just like many of us don't know what is going on until there is an announcement. I want to provoke you this evening to make up your mind that I will stand upon my watch. I will stand. Except you are not tired of the people dying and death every other month. You are summoning the family for burial, looking for coffin. So much so that the coffin business has become so lucrative. Sometimes the whole shelves are empty. Because that Friday, they came and took all the 12 coffins that the man labored to make. All the 12 coffins sold in one day. Ambulances coming to fetch coffins. Who will stand for God and say, I will stand here until he answers me? You need to study the book of Psalms and see the doggedness of David. Sometimes when he's discouraged, you speak to his soul. My soul, why are you discouraged? Trust in the Lord. This David speaking to his soul. Just like you get discouraged, maybe you pray for 3 days, pray for 17 days, and the kind of answers you were expecting didn't come. David will speak to his soul. My soul, calm down. Sometimes the race is not a sprint. It's a marathon. And only those that have the capacity to endure will last. I will still be standing when the race is finished. And I will receive the intelligence to undo the powers of darkness in my space. You need a determination to watch. Can we pray today? Tell God how determined you are. I'll be that man standing, creating earthly permission for heavenly interference because of my labor. The people under my jurisdiction will see light. I stand on the behalf of myself. I stand on behalf of my children. I stand on behalf of them of my household. I stand and I'll keep standing. I'll keep standing. I'll never be weary until there is an announcement.
I want to encourage everyone who has followed and is following, please, I want you to share this video, let it go around the world and bless somebody.